You see, are Gilles Villemure of the New York Rangers and Jacques Plante wearing the mask for the Toronto Maple Leafs, who defend the south end of our right, the New York Rangers, the north end of the left. Your officials are Wally Harris, number 11. He's the referee with the two orange armbands above the elbow. And the two linesmen are Claude Bouchard, number 22. Pat Shetler is 20. That's Walter Kachuk, 18 at center ice. Dave Ballone is 17. And number 10 is Billy Fairburn on the right wing. Keon with McMillan and Monahan out there for the Maple Leafs. Monahan, number 20, in possession. Back of the net. He's checked by Ballone. Picked up by Rick Lee, number 2. Lee starts out. Off the boards for Monahan. Broken up by Fairburn, but it was offside to Dave Ballone. And they're starting rather quickly, Bob, in this first period.
We tested that young Leaf defense by throwing it in there, but on the first exchange, they would be about even right now.
Keon gets the draw back to Glennie. Glennie, number 24, to Rick Lee. Leaf flip one ahead for Keon, but it's offside from inside the blue line over the red line at center. Captain of the Maple Leafs take Keon, number 14, facing off with Walter Kachuk. Rick Lee picks it off, flips it up to Keon at center. Keon gets it to the line, but not over. Ballone steered it out without looking. Glennie brings it back. He's knocked down by Jimmy Nielsen, number 15. Ballone is given a check by McMillan. Back comes Fairburn. Over the blue line, a drop pass to Kachuk, and he shot it 10 feet wide. Keon, the rebound, off the boards, coming straight down at center. He's got McMillan on his right. And for Monahan. Monahan is grabbed by Fairburn. The puck is against the boards, and they're going to hold it there for a faceoff.
Cash in on the cold weather protection of Esso-Rad antifreeze. Now only $2.95 a gallon at participating Esso dealers.
Sillaps is at center ice for the New York Rangers now, number 6, with Bob Nevin, 8 on the right wing, Hatfield on the left. Here's a chance for Ullman, a backhand. In front for Henderson. Henderson back to Ullman. There's the shot of great save as Ellis missed the rebound. Brad Park carrying it along for Hatfield. Hatfield gets it out to center ice, Danny Brown. Flips one at Plon. Handled it easily and flipped it into the corner. Sillaps trying to center it, he did. It goes to the far wing, poked out by Ronnie Ellis. Hatfield's back for it, number 11. Hatfield to Brad Park. Park's pass up for Apps. Broken up. Rangers still maintain possession. Arnie Brown shooting the puck between Selwood and Dory. That's over the red line. Icing will be the call against the New York Rangers. There's no score with 18:09 to play in the first period.
Well, there's a face that's not too familiar to our viewers, but a name that certainly will bring back a lot of fond memories, Sillaps Jr. Certainly, sometimes looking at these young fellows makes you feel your age.
Ullman facing off against Apps, who got the draw with the Villemure. It's deflected near that New York Ranger goal. Brad Park having difficulty getting untracked. He's stopped by Ullman, who's up there forechecking him. Ullman ends up in the mesh, as you can see. And with the puck held against the back of the net, referee Wally Harris calls the play, and we're going to get a complete change of players by both teams as Walton comes out to center ice for the Maple Leafs with number 12, Jim Harrison, on the right wing, and number 26, Bob Liddington, on the left. That's Jean Rattel, Rod Gilbert, and Egers. There's a shot by Glennie at the side of the net. Liddington gets the puck for the Leafs, trying to center it. He's given a bump. It's shot across the goal mouth. Picked up by Egers. Egers of New York coming up the center. Pass to Rattel and Gilbert, and Rattel was hit hard by Glennie, and he gets up slowly. Mike Walton up the center. Over the line. A pass to Harrison. Harrison cutting in. Took a shot. It's right across the front of the net. Harrison keeps it in. Takes his shot. Walton was sitting in front of the net, but he couldn't get the pass. Back comes Rattel. Up at center. Over the blue line, offside was Eagers on the left side and Gilbert on the right, and they're really playing great hockey here at Maple Leaf Gardens tonight. Both teams. No score in the game. We have 17 minutes and 14 seconds to go in the first period. Rattel facing off against Walton. He got the draw. Comes back to number three, Tim Horton. His shot was weak. Rick Lee. A pass to Lidington to Mike Walton. He can't get out. It's broken up by Rattel. He gets his shot and blocked. Got his hand in the way of that. Gilbert's pass. Knocked down. He gets it again, though. Walton had a piece of it but couldn't break away. Rattel to Gilbert. He's over the line. Eagers takes his shot. Knocked down by Plon. Rick Lee gets tied up back of the net. Falls on the puck. No further play. Toronto nothing. New York Rangers nothing. 16:43 to play in the first period. Don Luce, number 14 at center ice now for the New York Rangers. Ronnie Stewart, number 12 on the right wing. And on the left side, Ted Urban. The puck is picked up by Keon, back of the Ranger net, trying to center it. It's knocked back to Ernie Brown. Brown trying to bring it out. He's knocked out of the play. Monahan went after it. Picked up by Luce. Luce shoots it into the Leaf zone. It bounces to Plott, and Dory's there. Dory. Back it goes. Selwood up for Keon. Trying to get away from Brad Park. A pass for McMillan. He's over the line, but he was taken out of the play. The puck picked off by Stewart. Stewart around to Brad Park. He's stopped by Monahan, but it goes to Stewart. Ron Stewart back of the New York Ranger goal. Shot it off the boards. Dory covered loose, and the puck goes to Selwood. Selwood just gets rid of it into the New York Ranger zone. Brad Park, number two, is there. Trying to pick his way out with a pass to Luce. Luce coming over his own blue line to center. Knocked down by Selwood. Selwood breaks back for the Leafs with Keon. Selwood just shoots the puck in. Keon goes in after it with Stewart. Stewart checked by McMillan. Ernie Brown back in the net. He gets it up on the wing to Stewart. A back pass to Luce. With Irvin on the left wing. Takes the pass over the line. Gets his shot. Plant's got that. He's going to hold it. And that's one thing that Plant does, Bob, is not get rid of that puck when his two defensemen are nowhere near him.
Well, in that case, he had Selwood and Dory turned the other way, and there was no way he could clear that into the corner and expect him to pick it up, so he wisely held the puck and got a faceoff. And this is the thing. He had control of that puck in his own end.
Hellman lost the draw to Waller Kachuk. Dave Ballone gets it back to the blue line. Horton shoots it. Oh, and Jack Plott did the splits and picked that puck up with his left hand right off his right toe.
Here's Plott taking that glove hand of his and going over to his far side and making a tremendous save. Headed for that bottom left-hand corner.
On the face-off, the puck is still in the lead zone. Knocked down was Walter Kachuk. Rick Lee with it. Up to Henderson. Henderson's pass missed Ullman, and it's way offside as it was shot from outside the Leaf blue line with two Rangers trapped inside. 14 minutes, 51 seconds to go in the first period. Walter Kachuk is 18. Billy Fairburn is 10. Dave Ballone is 17. Rod Seeling, 16. And Tim Horton, number three, for the New York Rangers. There's Ricky Lee nearly giving the puck to Kachuk. Ellis comes back at center to Ullman over the line. Flipped it through for Ellis. He shoots. Villemier snapped that, and they pile up in front of him. As Ullman put Ellis in.
A nice play at that Ranger blue line by Normie Ullman. And just flipping that puck past that left defenseman, and Ellis on the break didn't have enough room to come back out in front. Villemure holding his ground and cutting off the angle, but it was a nice play by Ullman and Ellis.
Asoff in the New York Rangers zone, as you saw Blown and Henderson jump offside. Delone gets the puck back to Seeling. Seeling back in the net, waits. Katkachuk on his left. Seeling coming up to his own blue line, up the center. Shot the puck in. Lenny back for it, shot it around on the board. Stopped by Horton. Horton keeps it in. Ahern couldn't center it. Elman now tries his luck in his own zone. Flipped it right in front of the net, Ricky Lee. Falls. Fairburn went after it, but Lee fell down and covered up.
Bill, in our first intermission tonight, Ward will talk with the Leafs' Jimmy Harrison, and we'll have a look at the Rangers on film. I think that'll be an interesting film.
Mm-hmm. Now, this is quite a line out there now. Sillaps with Nevin and Hatfield. Selwood of the Leafs, number three, back of the net. Being forechecked by Apps. Puck was shot down the ice. Arnie Brown going back for it for the New York Rangers. There's no score in the hockey game, and we have 13:48 remaining in this first period. The Leafs stop the Rangers coming out of their own zone. They'll try it again. Apps comes down the right wing over the line, closing in, dropped it back, and here's Walton going down the ice. He's got Lennington with him. One man back. Walton shoots. Oh, Benavir made a good save on that. Back up for New York. Nevin at center ice. Hatfield on the left. The pass to Hatfield. Hatfield centered it. Nevin goes to the boards, flips it back. Now then Hatfield and Harrison mixing it up. And you see they're swinging at long range. Two linesmen trying to keep them apart, Harrison and Hatfield. This is the second brawl that Jimmy Harrison has been involved in. He was involved against St. Louis' Noel Picard and Bob Plager on Wednesday, and now he's into the fracas with Hatfield of the New York Rangers.
This is the engine cleaner additive we're now blending into both SO and SO Extra gasoline. It helps maintain your car's performance because it helps prevent the buildup of engine deposits. And since both SO and SO Extra have the engine cleaner, you should know which grade is best for your car and your kind of driving. The type of car you drive and the way you drive it can make a difference in the grade of gasoline you should use. For drivers that demand more from their car, we blend extra octane into SO Extra. It's the high-octane gasoline for cars with high-compression engines. The higher octanes in SO Extra can also help an engine that knocks or lacks power response. SO regular gasoline is blended for those cars with lower compression engines and for less severe driving demands. Both SO and SO Extra gasolines contain a number of additives, including the engine cleaner, to help your engine deliver all the performance it was designed for. That's why we call both SO and high-octane SO Extra the performance gasoline.
In the penalty box are Harrison and Hatfield. Major penalties each for fighting at 6:42. There's no score in the game. Of course, with offsetting major penalties, while they were the two teams are at full strength. On the faceoff, Keon fights for it. Lost the puck. It comes back to the blue line. Nielsen takes his shot. It's near the Leaf goal, and Monahan covers up. Harry Monahan gets away from Rattel. Coming out with a puck for Keon and McMillan. Keon at center. He goes over the line with Monahan. Closing in, Monahan backhands on a deflection and just missed the target. Rod Gilbert getting it over on the wing. It was shot down the ice by number 20, Jack Egers. He's go back for it. McMillan giving it to Dory. Dory up at center. Here goes the long shot. Off the target, rebounds out to Villemure to Rod Gilbert. He's checked by McMillan and knocked down. John Rattel flipping it up for Jack Egers at center, wrapping it for Nielsen. Nielsen just missed a heavy check from Bill McMillan. Monahan back there with Keon, who takes the pass. Then McMillan helps him out, brings it up at center, takes a long shot. Villemure flipping it off to Gilbert, off the board, stopped by Keon, and Gilbert's back there for it. Gets it over on the left side, cleared by Eagers out the center ice. Ricky Lee shoots it right back in again. That's Rod Seelig, number 16, with 11:44 to go in the first period. There's still no score. Eagers to Gilbert. A long shot is off the target. Ellis flipped it out. Nielsen flips it back in again, and it's offside as Gilbert was at least 20 feet inside the blue line. Kachuk, number 18, with Fairburn on the right side and Malone on the left. Ullman, Henderson. Henderson took the pass and lost it at the blue line. It's cleared by Kachuk to Fairburn. There's his shot, and he shot it high and wide. Malone, covered by Ullman. They go to the boards, and they hold it there for a faceoff. Out of town at Montreal, Coro from Dennis Hull and Jarrett. Chicago leads the Canadiens 1-0 at 3:25, first period. Here's a chance for Ellis. Going down with Henderson, one man back. They're over the line. Ellis closing in to Henderson. He shoots the score!
There's a perfectly played goal with a two-on-one break, and Ronnie Ellis bringing that puck up the right side, but watch Henderson drop back to give him somebody to pass it to. Tim Horton plays it perfectly down the middle, and as soon as that puck hits Henderson's stick, it's gone and beats Villemure over his right shoulder up in the top corner. Beautiful play.
Toronto goal scored by number 19, Henderson. Assist, number 6, Ellis, and number 9, Ullman. The time, 8:53.
8:53 is the official time of Henderson's goal from Ellis and Ullman. Toronto leads 1-0 over the New York Rangers. Dory back for it. Covered by Apps. Lennington gets in there as well, but Apps covers him and there's no further play. There you see the score. Toronto 1, New York Rangers 0. 10 minutes and 54 seconds to go in this, the first period. Dory to Wolf. Back to Dory. Dory straight down the ice at center to Lennington on the left wing. Back to Wolf. Walton closing in, and he's shot by Dory, who was just ready to put that puck in the corner. He went too far. Seelig around on the left side. Rangers at center. Apps coming over the line with Irvin. Apps takes his shot, deflected wide, goes back in the net. Trying to come out in front. Back it comes to Seelig. Here's his shot. Claude easily covered that. Trache is out there for the first time, playing on the right wing with Walton and Lidington. Number 11, Guy Trache. Ryan Glennie back for it with 10:07 remaining first period. 1-0 for the Maple Leafs. Lidington to Glennie. Well, he tried to get a pass to Trache and it failed to work. Nielsen then to Rattel, number 19. He goes over the line, breaks through the defense. Oh, a clock came out and checked him. Jack Klotz stuck his stick out and checked the Ranger player before he could get a shot away. And Rattel made a terrific play by splitting the defense. Rick Lee to Keon, up to Monahan, over the line. There's his shot, a hard one, but McMillan was offside on the right wing.
Bilbert, we're going to get another look at that play by John Rattel. Look at that shift he put on Brian Glennie. Come in here and Rick Lee can't quite reach him, but Plant played that poke check beautifully. He's got that stick out at least 15 feet in front of him and swept it off Rattel's stick.
9 minutes and 32 seconds remain in the first period. 1-0 for the Maple Leafs. Brad Park after it. Harrison and Hatfield still serving their major penalties for fighting. A long shot. Plant steered that off to the side. It's Monahan into McMillan. Then to Monahan. Monahan comes up at center. He gets over the line. Centered for Keon. Keon after it, and McMillan, broken up by Joe Baird to Rattell, and back came Monahan and knocked him down. Went down two. Puck is cleared into the Rangers zone. There's Keon after it. Rad Park up to Jack Egers. Egers number 20 to Rattell 19. Here they go, up over the Leaf line. Joe Baird gets the puck, takes a shot, he scores! By Joe Baird, perfect shot.
You know, this goes to prove it's a game of mistakes. Here's a miscue on his play by Rattell. Really didn't mean to leave that puck there. Here, hit Joe Baird right on the skate and stayed with him all the way through, and he beat Plante on the low shot to the corner. Plante didn't quite get his foot over there, but I think the key on that play is the fact that Rattell tried to take the puck with him.
New York goal scored by number 7, Gilbert. Assist, number 20, Egers, and number 2, Park. The time, 11:17.
11:17 is the time as Ellis fails to get a whoop by Malone. Malone is dumped. Allman trying to bring the puck out, gets it to Ellis. Stopped by Walter Kachuk. He's checked by Ellis. Puck was shot into the corner, came out, not giving it to Dory. Score is tied, 1-1. 8 minutes and 9 seconds remain in the first period. Dave Ballone broke up that play by Dory. Rangers moving up. There's a shot that's wide. Fairburn in the corner. He's covered. Dory bumped into him. Now then, Selwood off the boards for Henderson. He gets it to the line, but not out. Fairburn, it's Kachuk. And Selwood finally gets it out. Dave Ballone. A flip pass for Kachuk. He's hit. Lenny missed him with a second try. Elman tried to get away. Here's a chance for Fairburn. Over the line. Nice loop off. They get it again. Kachuk tried to center it. Goes loose. Here's Nielsen's shot. Can't stop that. He's got it. Nearly had another fight, this time between Walter Kachuk and Brian Glennie. That's some very bad clearing in front of that Leaf net bar.
Well, Plante had to come up with a big save there after the Leafs were guilty, as you said, of a bad clearing and poor possession. And I think this is something we'll probably find throughout the winter, Bill, with the youth that the Leafs are carrying on that club this year. They're going to make some mistakes, and they need somebody like Plante in there to study them down in their own end, especially.
Puck goes to the corner. Glennie shooting it to the blue line, but not out. Liddington fell. Apps kept it in. Nevin goes after it in the corner. Hatfield is back out after serving his major penalty, along with Harrison. Harrison is out there as well. Here's Apps getting it back to Brown. His shot is knocked down, and the Leafs now with Wolf. Up to Harrison. Up at center. This pass for Liddington failed to click. And by Ricky Lee. And Lee has to go back into his own zone. Then to Mike Walt, who's in full flight. Straight up the ice to Walt. He's checked by Brad Park, and Nevin tried to set Apps away and failed. Harrison clearing the puck over the line. He and Hatfield having a private feud. Brad Park then up to Apps. Cleared it for Nevin offside over the line. And after having watched that replay of the goal by Gilbert, and not the official score did not mention Rattell, I'm sure there'll be a change on that.
Well, he was the one that made the play possible, even though it was, they said before, a miscue, a big count. Bill, I want our viewers to know that next Saturday, the Rangers will be at the Forum for a game of the Montreal Canadiens, while here in Toronto, the Chicago Blackhawks will be the visitors.
Toronto 1, New York Rangers 1. We're in the first period with 6 minutes and 23 seconds to go. Selwood off the boards to McMillan, to Keon. Keon straight down the ice, over the line, stops. Passes it for Monahan. Monahan in the corner. He's covered by Luce. Puck goes loose. Keon tried to hold it against the boards. Luce gets in there, finally. It's held for a faceoff, and the fans are objecting to the fact that Don Luce grabbed the Leafs. I think the Leaf player was holding his arm anyway. All set to go. Keon lost the draw. The New York Rangers with Nielsen to Stewart. Getting it up to Irvin. Irvin over the line, trying to get by Selwood. Stops, centered it, and it goes to plot off to the side of the net. Selwood around on the boards to Monahan. Monahan gets it up at center. Keon couldn't reach it. Monahan's got it again. Over for McMillan to Keon. Keon's over the line. Keon shoots. Oh, and Bellemere got a piece of it. It was a high-rising shot. McMillan pointing into the boards. Keon is knocked down. McMillan is given an elbow. It comes back to the blue line. There's the shot. McMillan after it again. Send it to Keon. And it was stopped and play is called at a penalty to the New York Rangers. Irvin, number 27.
Ultimate tire. It's forever. It could go on for 50,000 miles or more. The radial. Six plies and 50,000 miles thick. The Atlas Mark V radial. Built to stay alive for a long, long time. Built to give you a chance to do the same.
Face off in the New York Rangers zone. It's shot down the ice by Brad Park. It's Ullman, Ellis, Henderson, Walton, and Lee. 5 minutes and 8 seconds remain in the first period. It's a 1-1 tie. New York Rangers 1, Toronto 1. Leafs with a man advantage. A pass for Henderson offside at the blue line. Faceoff will be where the play was made, just on the Leafs side of the checkered line at center. Keon is coming out now to replace Lee. So you now have five forwards. Ullman, Henderson, Ellis, Walton, and Keon. 1:41 remaining in the penalty. Walton to Keon, off the boards for Henderson. Henderson failed to get it by Brad Park. Gives it to Keon again, over to Mike Walton, to Ullman, for Ellis. Ellis is dumped, passed it back. Here's a chance for Keon. It hit him. Nevin knocked it out. Walton covers up to Keon. Keon at center. To the line and over. Flips it into the corner. Ullman after it. Ullman giving it to Keon. And he carried it outside the blue line. Walton to Henderson. Back to Keon. Keon leads four of them up over the line. Brad Park took it away from him and shoots it down the ice. And so far the Leafs haven't been effective while they've had the man advantage. There's Plott coming way out to start them off quickly. Tip through. Here's Ellis. Beautiful shot by Mike Walton.
Here's opportunity as Ellis takes that puck through the defenseman's leg and Villemure way out of his net to make a stick save on it. The puck came right back in the open with Villemure out of position. Mike Walton just calmly picked the top corner of that net and fired it home.
Toronto goal scored by number 16, Walton. Assist number 6, Ellis, and number 9, Ullman. The time, 15:59.
The official time was 15:59. It was scored with Irvin in the penalty box for elbowing. Teams are back at full strength. Selwood gave the puck away to Fairburn. Plott knocked it back. Walter Kachuk being covered. Nice hit there. It goes back in the net to Kachuk again. He gets it back to Nielsen. Nielsen hit him. And number 27, Darryl Sittler, got the puck out to center ice. Nielsen of New York. Trying to bring it back to Walter Kachuk over the line. There's his shot. He just missed the target. Plott reached for it, but it was off the mark. Harrison just wraps it down the ice with 3 minutes and 19 seconds left. There's going to be icing. Nielsen touches it. There's the linesman raising his arm.
If your car does these things, then it needs new Atlas Deluxe shock absorbers. Now only $8.88 apiece at participating Esso dealers.
Faceoff will be in the Maple Leaf zone to the left. Paulie Kachuk with Dave Ballone and Bill Fairburn. Out of town score. It's all tied up now at Montreal. Peter Mahovlich from Richard at 9:57. Dave Keon trying to work his way out. Gives it to Glennie. Glennie back to Keon at center. He goes over to the Ranger line. Dropped it for Monahan. Monahan still with it. Finally covered by Kachuk. And it's Rod Seeling feeding it to Fairburn over his stick. Glennie's going back for it. Up to Monahan. Monahan's pass is to Keon. Then to Rick Lee, who moves out. He takes a long shot. Villemier had it bounced by. Monahan with a shot goal. He's trying to center it again. Seeling had him covered. Monahan got it up in front of the net, but the Rangers bring it back. Fairburn over to Nielsen with 2:32 remaining in the first period. 2-1 for the Maple Leafs. McMillan covered him. Not just let it go to the corner. Glennie went after Fairburn. Fairburn decides to hold it. Gets it to Kachuk to Ballone. Ballone, number 17, was checked by Elman. Elman shoots it to an open wing. McMillan was leaving the ice. Ellis wasn't out. He's out there now. Arnie Brown. Bumped by Ellis. Rick Lee to Monahan's. Fairburn picked it off, flips it back in again, and this is where the Leafs get themselves in trouble in their own zone. As the Rangers try to forecheck them, Horton's pass right on Ellis' stick. And Ellis just failed to get loose. It's Rattel out there with Gilbert and Egers. Rangers over the line. Monahan fails to get it out. Egers was hit before he could get a shot away, and it's Rick Lee passing it out to center ice. 1:32 remaining in the first period. Toronto 2, New York Rangers 1. Over to Gilbert. There's a shot off Glennie that deflects into the corner. That's Rick Lee, number 2, passing it for Henderson. Mikhail stopped him. Elman now gets Henderson going on the left wing. Henderson. Pass for Ellis. It rolls over the line. Offside the second time as Ellis was inside a New York Ranger blue line ahead of Ellis. Henderson, Gilbert, and Mike Walton have been the goal scorers in this first period. There's been 3 penalties, 2 to the Rangers and 1 to the Leafs. And that's the way it is at 1:06 in the remaining in the first period. Toronto 2, New York Rangers 1.
Last minute of play
Brown,
in this
pass
period.
Pass for Horton, nowhere near him. Dory comes up with it for the Maple Leafs. Dory stick handles the center, gives it for Ullman. Ullman couldn't control it. John Rattel, covered by Selwood. Brad Selwood fought for it. Ullman did too. Rattel shoots it to an open wing. There's nobody there. Henderson back to Dory. His pass, Egers. Missed a body check from Walton. Here it's over for Gilbert. Dory gets in ahead of him. Dory. A long pass for Mike Walton. And Villemier let that one go. It seemed to get a piece of him, so there's going to be no icing. And we have 19 seconds left, but a long play from Dory to Walton, and Villemier just seemed to be watching the wrong way, but the shot was off the target. Just got a piece of his pad as it was going by the goalpost. Leafs playing every man up. Walton, Liddington, and Harrison. Lee and Glennie all inside the blue line. It's Walter Kachuk, number 18 from the New York Rangers, who got the draw, gives it back to Jimmy Nielsen. Nielsen back of the net, trying to come out. He was hit by Liddington. Up the ice comes Nevin with 10 seconds to Kachuk. He hit with Lee Harrison. For Walton, missed him as Nielsen got over to cover up. It rolls in front. Glennie shoots it out. 1 second left. Seeling gets it. As the bell goes to end the first period, as the Toronto Maple Leafs lead the New York Rangers by a score of 2-1. From Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto, Hockey Night in Canada. Starting their second period, that's Sillaps, number 6 at center ice, with Hadfield on the left wing, number 11. Nevin is 8 on the right side. Keon with McMillan and Monahan, Glennie and Rick Lee. Shot back to Nielsen. He shot the puck back into the leaf zone, and going back for it is Glennie. He'll touch it. Icing will be the call. They finally made the official correction on that goal by Gilbert. Rattel did get the assist along with Egers, as you saw on the videotape replay in the first period, in which Rattel actually attempted the stick handle around the Leaf defenseman, lost it, but it went to Gilbert. Hatfield bringing the puck out now, shot at the center ice, stopped by Rick Lee, then broken up by Sealing. Now Glennie will try his luck, shot it over the line. Nielsen goes after it in his own zone. McMillan beat him to it. Keon tried to get up there as well. The puck comes loose. Rick Lee digs it out along the boards. Took his shot, and that hit Apps and went to center ice. Glennie shoots it right back in again. The Leafs were onside. Villemure comes out of the net. Sealing got all tangled up with him. Keon kicks it loose to McMillan, and he just failed to put it in the corner. McMillan back to Keon. Back for McMillan again. Broken up by Nielsen to Hatfield, and he just shot it down the ice. And the ice is very fast here at Maple Leaf Gardens tonight, and the two teams are taking advantage of it. This game is coming to you from Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto.
Export has a great taste that stays great brew after brew, and you can count on that.
Aesop is in the New York Rangers zone to the left. Elman, Henderson, Ellis, Selwood, and Dory inside the blue line. Rangers got the draw. He shot to the corner. Bill Fairburn has it, number 10. He's watched by Henderson. Elman is shoved out of the play. The puck is still in the New York Rangers zone. Elman up doing some forechecking. Brad Park back in the net, covered by Elman. Brad Park hit by Henderson. Henderson tries to get it loose, and Kachuk comes up with it. Kachuk fails to get out as he hit Elman. Arnie Brown and Ellis. Elman failed to stop the play. New York Rangers get it out, and it's Arnie Brown bringing it up. To center. Go to the blue line to Kachuk. Rolled it in front, and Plante scooped it back in the net to Dory. Off the boards for Ellis. Ellis is covered by Kachuk. Kachuk holds him there. Dory gets it loose, and Jim Dory goes back in the net. Dory shoots it down the ice as he couldn't find a man in the open, and it's going over the red line. Brad Park will go back to touch it. He does. It's icing called against the Maple Leafs. Toronto Maple Leafs 2, New York Rangers 1, 17 minutes and 59 seconds to go in this, the second period. Aesop is in the Maple Leaf zone to the left. That's Rattel, Gilbert, and Egers. And the faceoff, Glennie flipped it for Liddington. Liddington was knocked down. Glennie shot it back in the net. Rick Lee has it. Lee's pass for Walton. Walton up at center, trying to get around Nielsen. Does, gets his shot away, and he just missed the target. He's knocked down. Egers brings it out to his own blue line up the center. He takes a long shot that's wide of the net. Liddington took his man out. There's a shot by Horton, and that was just wide of the corner. Rebound came all the way to center. Nielsen is knocked down by Walt. Toronto 2, New York Rangers 1, second period. Liddington straight down the ice for the Leafs. Over the line. Missed a check from Nielsen. Villemure shot the puck into the corner. Harrison tried to cover his check. Horton's got it back in the net. Gets away from Walton. Gets it up on the wing to Egers. Egers going down with Gilbert on the right side. Plott came out of the net. Rattel takes his shot. Plott covered that. It's sent it out front again for Gilbert. Gilbert shoots right in front of the net. And it goes off to the corner. Harrison trying to get it out. Stopped by Nielsen. And it's broken up by Rick Lee to Keon. It was kicked ahead, and play was called for a faceoff where the puck was kicked ahead rather than played with a stick. And that was a tough break for the Leafs, Bob.
Here's the save on that pickup by Gilbert. The shot is blocked by Glennie and bounces up in the air and comes right at Rattel's feet, and Plante, moving out, blocked the shot. But that's right on the wrong people's stick at the right time.
Don Luce, number 14 at center ice now for the New York Rangers, with Irvin on the left wing, Stewart on the right. Keon with McMillan and Monahan. It's Keon straight up at center. A long shot, that's grabbed by Villemure. Villemure shot it off the glass. Goes to Luce. Luce up over his own blue line, that's center. To Irvin. Irvin trying to cut in, taken out of the play by Selwood. Gets it loose into the corner. Dory after it. Dory gets the puck and gets it up to Keon. Keon's passes to McMillan and off the stick. Arnie Brown right out of Dory's stick. It's against the boards. Goes loose. Here's Keon with McMillan. McMillan right in front of the net. Coming up now is Selwood. He faked the shot. Still has it. Passed it to Keon. And a pass to the puck was broken up. Straight up the ice comes Brad Park. Over for Luce. Selwood had him covered. Plot is way out of the net. Shot it around right to Stewart. Stewart came out in front. They take two whacks at it. Dory goes down. Monahan comes up with it for the Leafs. He's going to try and hold it against the boards. He does. And we have 15 minutes and 29 seconds remaining in the second period. This is Hockey Night in Canada from Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto.
And now, Molson Canadian entertains.
Molson Canadian, a lot of beer that's bright and clear. Molson Canadian, it drinks so smooth any time of year. Drink Molson Canadian lager beer.
So when it's your turn to entertain, choose Molson Canadian lager beer. It's the crowd pleaser.
Toronto 2, New York Rangers 1, as we get set for a face-off in the Leafs zone, a false start. Anderson jumping offside. That's Sillaps at center, number 6, with Hatfield and Nevin on the wings. Lenny was checked. It's speared right in front of the net. Hatfield shoots. Another shot was stopped by Plonoff. Nevin. Hellman trying to get the puck out. Nevin. A back pass for Hatfield. Hatfield covered by Rick Lee. Gets the boards, and there's no further play. 15:09 remaining in the second period. Rangers are playing every man up, Horton and Stealing inside the blue line at the defense. On the faceoff, it's Nevin. He's trying to turn. Hellman gets it up to Ellis. Ellis fails to get it out. Now then, Rick Lee for Ellis. By Sealing. Broken up by Hatfield. Hatfield's pass for Nevin. Back to Hatfield. Over the line. He's closing in. There's the shot, and it's wide. Henderson gets the rebound. Shot it back of the net to Glennie. Round on the boards to Ellis. Ellis launched it to Sealing. A shot stopped by Glennie's skate. And the Leafs are hard-pressed in their own zone. It's cleared up the center ice. Tipped right back to Hatfield. Over the line for Amps. Back to Hatfield. Over for Nevin. And it's broken up by Glennie. Glennie over to Henderson. Henderson can't get out. Nevin centered it right across the goal mouth. Ellis lost it to Hatfield. Now then, Ricky Lee dives on top of the puck. And there's no further play. And boy, the Rangers are putting on terrific pressure, Bob.
That line has certainly been buzzing with Apps and Bob Nevin and Vic Hatfield, and they kept the Leafs pretty well pinned in there for their full two-minute shift.
14 minutes and 15 seconds to go in the second period. Toronto 2, New York Rangers 1. The New York Rangers, Walter Tkachuk, number 18, Dave Ballone, 17, and Billy Fairburn, number 10. That's Walton out there with Liddington and Harrison. And Selwood. Take the pass, brings it out himself, gets it to Mike Walton. Walton tried to go over the line. Harrison waiting for him to get back onside. Didn't wait long enough. Offside. Faceoff will be outside the New York Ranger blue line. Walton to Dory, flipped the puck into the Rangers zone. Brad Park to Tkachuk. Walton is there again, and then he lost it. Arnie Brown with it. Arnie Brown, a pass over the line. There's Plott way out of the net again. Whittington goes to the boards. He's going to try and hold it there again. The puck is loose. Dory comes up with it. Dory coming out. With Walton. Harrison waits for his teammates to get onside as Walton is way inside the Ranger zone. Brad Selwood gets it into the New York zone. Villemure out of the net to Ernie Brown. Ernie Brown will start now with Walter Kachuk. Ahead to Fairburn, over the blue line. Dory bumped into him. Harrison is draped along the boards, and Dory moves in to cover up. Jim Dory to Jim Harrison. To Mike Walton. Checked by Ernie Brown. Fairburn goes in. Dory bumped into him. Walton tried to center it. Claude knocked it into the corner. Leafs are tied up in their own zone. It's right out of the puck to Malone and went off the stick. Jimmy Harrison goes back to the Leaf net. He flips one high down the ice at center. Ernie Brown gets there first. Leafs are trying to change on the goal. Brown goes back into his own zone with 12:36 left in the second period. And the Leafs lead 2-1 with the New York Rangers threatening. That's Sean Rattel, number 19. He's bumped. Comes back to Brad Park. Here goes the shot. And that was deflected off Gilbert wide. Harrison lapped it, not out. Annie Brown, in attempting to pass, cleared it out. Dave Ballone over the blue line. Out and in again, outside. Rattel was inside the blue line. But no doubt that the New York Rangers are carrying the play to the Maple Leafs at the moment, Bob.
Well, they've had pressure on that Leaf club continuing this period, and if they keep it up like this, there could be a little bit of trouble in that Toronto end.
New York Rangers shoot the puck in. Claude came way out of that. He's got it, and he's going to hold it. And that was a bouncer. And he made no mistake, but it's amazing how he can move so quickly on those skates. He should have been a forward.
Got tremendous maneuverability. He always has had, and he certainly hasn't lost any of it.
Lenny is covered back of the net. We'll have another faceoff. Interesting to see how fast he can skate against the defensive court without those heavy pads on. There's the score. Toronto 2, New York Rangers 1. 11:58 to go in the second period. Comes back to Joe Barry. Faked the shot back to Nielsen. His shot is high. It's bouncing, and it's grabbed by Plott. And he held it. What they call the slow ball. Davey Keon out there at center with Monahan on the left wing and McMillan on the right. Back to Nielsen again. Here goes the shot. Right on. Keon slips in front of the defense. Plott gets a hold of it. He shot it into the corner. Lenny is checked. It's out in front. Oh, and Joe Bear was knocked flat. It's Plott getting it again. And the Leafs just can't get out. This is Hockey Night in Canada from Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto.
You know, to fully enjoy a Bolton Export Ale, you don't have to catch that lucky brass ring. Some things are good enough on their own, without a lot of extra frills. Like the taste of a Molson Export Ale, always great. And isn't this what drinking beer is all about? Good friends and Molson Export. Export has a taste that stays great, and you can count on that.
Molson Export Ale keeps on tasting great.
Face off in the lead zone on the left. Plott is talking to Dory. Puck is dropped. Rattel trying to center it. Dory fails to get it out. There's a shot of Plott's knocked down. Ellis shooting it down the ice. Steeling goes back for it, but it won't be icing. Henderson took him out of the play. Hellman centering it. Ellis couldn't control it. Then he backhanded one. The ceiling breaks up and shoots to center ice. That's Eagers to Gilbert. Back to Eagers. Rangers closing in. Stopped by Dory. And Rattel was looking for a loose puck. Dory's going to the boards with it with a skate. The puck came loose. Gilbert trying to center it. Dory flips it into the crowd. And the Leafs are really desperate in their own zone at this point in the hockey game.
There's a good look at that. Jack Eagers, a Sudbury-born native, and in two seasons with Omaha, he had a tremendous scoring years. Last year won the scoring title, had 42 goals and 48 assists down there, and this is the guy that Neil Francis says probably has the hardest shot of anybody breaking in the NHL.
10 minutes and 47 seconds to go in the second period. Toronto 2, New York Rangers 1. Don Luce, 14 at center. Irvin is 27, and Stewart is 12 for the New York Rangers. Elman, a long pass for Ellis, off the skate. He's still got it. He takes the shot. Another try. Elman, a backhand. Villemier got a hold of Elman's backhand, as it looked like he had the empty net.
We'll take a look at that one again, Bill. Ronnie Ellis playing that puck beautifully with his feet, keeping control. He has one shot as the rebound comes to him, gets another shot away. Villemier making two saves, way out of position, that puck. And Normie Elman coming in on his back and getting a quick shot away. And I believe that puck was stopped by the defense. Timmy Horton picked that puck up with Villemier out of position. Tremendous play by that New York defense.
Arnie Brown around on the boards. It's stopped by Rick Lee. He shoots it in back in the net. And the Rangers having difficulty coming out. And that seems to be the pattern of this hockey game tonight. First one team, then the other when they get in the other opposing zone. Zilaps coming back for New York. Gives it to Ernie Brown. Up for Hatfield. Over to Nevin. And a three of them closing in. And a pass for Zilaps. Just failed to click. Ellis for Elman. Elman races after it. Horton beat him to it. Horton over for Nevin. He and Henderson bumped together. Elman's pass for Ellis was hit by Hatfield and knocked down the ice into the lead zone. Passed over the boards by Hatfield. Ellis is knocked down by Apps. Play is called. And there'll be a face-off in the lead zone to the right. There's a penalty here to Hatfield. This is Hockey Night in Canada from Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto.
You know, to fully enjoy a Molson Export Ale, you really don't need a voyage to the bottom of the sea. Some things are good enough on their own, without a lot of frills. Like the taste of a Molson Export Ale, always great. And isn't this what drinking beer is all about? Comfortable surroundings and Export Ale. Molson Export has a taste that stays great, and you can count on that.
Molson Export Ale keeps on tasting great.
Well, a penalty is going to Zilaps, number six, apparently after Hatfield had rammed Lee into the boards. He bounced back, and then he was charged, apparently, by Apps, so he gets the penalty. So the Leafs, with a man advantage, 6-5, have Keon, Guy Trotche, number 11, Monahan, Selwood, and Walton. Nielsen, Rattel, Stewart, and Seeling for the New York Rangers. 9 minutes and 37 seconds to go in the second period. Leafs get the puck out, shot in again offside.
Here's an interesting shot of Eddie Jackman standing behind that New York Ranger bench. Now, I don't know whether he's standing because he's maybe nervous or probably because there isn't room in that bench, but it's not too often you see the spare goalkeeper standing up.
Trotche gets the puck back to Walton. Walton picking his way out now to center ice. There's four of them up. A pass for Keon was stopped at the defense. Selwood. Perry to Monahan. Monahan to Keon. Back to Monahan. Over the line with Trotche. Trotche in front. He just failed to get it. Here's a backhand by Walton. Trotche's got it again with a shot. And Walton missed the rebound. Selwood into the corner to Keon. Keon couldn't get it loose. Trotche trying to dig it out. It comes loose. It's shot down the ice by Jean Rattel. 8:47 remaining in the second period. Toronto Maple Leafs 2, New York Rangers 1. Mike Walton leading a four-man rush. For Keon, it was behind him. Stewart. And there'll be a face-off. 42 seconds left in Apps' penalty. 8:28 remaining in the second period. Toronto 2, New York Rangers 1.
On our second intermission tonight, we have something special, a computer predicting the final standings in both the East and West Division of the NHL. It'll be interesting to see how electronics make out with hockey, Bill.
Okay, Bob, that'll be very interesting. Shot down the ice. And it's Rick Lee going back for 33 seconds left in the penalty to Apps. Rick Lee's pass up to Ellis. Ellis coming down the right wing. Ballone after him. Took the puck away from him as he tried to pass it. Rad Park shooting it down the ice, and Lee's gone back for it. Lee with Walton. Walton streaking down the left wing. A pass for Walton. He's closing in. Takes his shot, and Villemier came way out of the net. A nice play again by Mike Walton. A patent play,
this is a preset play, Bill. If you watch him, and that Henderson took the wing into the center, and Walton moving down that outside with no check on him, and I think the puck was bouncing on him as he started to cut or started to shoot it, and he didn't get a very good shot away. But take a look at where that Villemier was when he blocked the shot. He had to be 20 feet out of his net.
7 minutes and 55 seconds to go. Here's a chance for Glennie, a shot. Henderson missed it. Walter Kachuk gets it. Apps getting set to return in 1 second. Ballone. Stick handling at center. Shot it for Apps. Apps was given a shove. Ellis failed to get loose. Rick Lee back for it. Over to Glennie. Off for Henderson. Broken up. Ballone. Now the Rangers into the weak zone. He's checked. Ullman for Henderson. Henderson back to Ullman. Ullman over the blue line. He's trying to go through, and he's knocked down. Back up for Ballone. Ballone at the blue line. At center, right on the Henderson stick. Back to Glennie, over to Rick Lee. He shot it right on to Fairburn stick. Here's Kachuka shot. That score! Fairburn got the rebound, and it's all tied up. 2-2. Fairburn from Kachuk.
Fairburn started the play. Passed it back to Walter Kachuk. Here, Kachuk almost having a shot blocked by Ricky Lee, but the puck got past him. Quant made the save, and the puck dropped right onto Fairburn's stick, and he poked it past Quant on the short side, put it in the corner of the net.
New York goal scored by number 10, Fairburn. Assist number 18, Kachuk. The time, 13:03
was the time of the goal by Fairburn from Kachuk. Nielsen waits, takes a long shot. Plant got that. Gives it to Dory. Dory coming out with Walton. Up at center. Slipped it in. Villemier back in the net to Nielsen. 6 minutes and 26 seconds to go in the second period. Down the ice for Rattel. He's over the line, getting in front of the defense, got his shot away, and Harrison is there. Jimmy Harrison. Hands on his first try, but gets it out to center. Eager's a long shot. Klaas steered that to the corner. Harrison to Dory, around to Liddington. Liddington failed to get it out. Rattel of New York, then to Gilbert. He's covered. Selwood shot it down the left wing, and Liddington goes after it, and Seeling beats him to it. Ceiling to Egers. Up at center ice for Rattel. Off Gilbert. Liddington and Ceiling bump together. It's Rattel over the line. He's checked. Now it's Harrison going back with Liddington over the line. Harrison still has it. Passed it back. There's a shot, and that's wide. Rattel for Gilbert, too far. Stopped by Dory. Dory flipped one in. Villemier caught that, left it for Ceiling. Harrison bumped him. Egers gets it up to Nevin. Nevin over the blue line, trying to go around. Glennie's turned around and knocked down, and there's going to be a penalty there to Glennie. And New York will have the odd man advantage in this second period with the score tied 2-2. New York 2, Toronto 2.
Here's a look at that penalty, and I imagine that Glennie was called. He put that stick between Nevin's leg and he twisted him as he went to his outside, and the referee called him.
Toronto penalty to number 24, Glennie. 2 minutes for holding. The time, 14:50.
Out-of-town score, Montreal now leads Chicago 4-1. Peter Mihaljevic from J.C. Tremblay and Béliveau at 5:26, and Mickey Redmond from Harper at 7:22. Back to Ernie Brown, there's his shot, and just grazed the goalpost. Grant Park fell, but kept the puck into Nevin. Then to Apps, back to Nevin. Nevin waits, trying to center it out in front. Rickley breaks it up. Gets it up to center ice. Tries to hold it there. Goes loose to Nevin. 4:44 remaining in the second period. Over the line to Ernie Brown. Back to Hatfield. Hatfield shoots. Might stop that. Nevin centered it. Hatfield took another shot. McMillan gets a backhand down the ice. That's Brad Park, getting it over on the right side to Apps. Apps straight up at center. He's got Nevin on his right. They're over the line, back to Nevin. There's the shot high off a leg. And it went over the glass. 4 minutes and 12 seconds to go in the second period. New York Rangers 2, Toronto 2. There's a minute and 2 seconds left in Glennie's penalty. Kachuk to Nielsen into Malone. Malone waits, gets it back to Nielsen. Nielsen trying to get Kachuk loose. Here's back to Horton, the shot. That's the fucking top by Claude. It comes to the blue line, but not out. Horton keeps it in to Fairburn. Fairburn trying to center it. Did. Across the goal mouth, it's shot out, the race for it. And goes after it with Horton, and Horton beat him to it. Horton's pass on the right wing to Fairbird. Over the line, Ellis shoots it out. Nielsen. To Kachuk, he's over the line. 21 seconds left for the penalty, a shot by Nielsen is wide. The rebound, Horton lets one go, that goes to the corner. Along to Kachuk, the center's goal! Makes it 3-2 New York.
Take a look at that play, but that line of Fairburn, Kachuk really working, and that puck came out to Kachuk in the center, and he didn't take too long to get rid of it. Beat Jock Plante over his right pad, but play well set up by Billy Fairburn digging in that corner for it.
New York goal scored by number 18, Kachuk. Assist, number 17, Ballone, and number 3, Horton. The time, 16:38.
Waller Kachuk scoring from Horton and Ballone at 16:38. New York Rangers shoot the puck into the Leafs zone. Ricky Lee holds it there, gets loose. Crutche giving it to Ullman. Shot it, but not out. Here's Brad Parker, drive, he scores! Brad Park makes it 4-2.
On another miscue on a Leaf left wing, throwing that puck up the center. Brad Park sneaking over into the spot with a wicked slap shot. This puck was in all the way, and Jock Plante never had a chance at all of that.
New York goal scored by number 2, Park, unassisted. The time, 16:53.
This game is coming to you from Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto.
Get the smooth taste you'll flip over. Molson Canadian. It's the crowd pleaser.
A
Now set for the faceoff in the lead zone. Walton gets the draw. It goes over to the wing. Horton keeps it in, ready to let the stick there as it was knocked out of his hands. Clearing pass for Egers to Rattel for Joe Bear. And that was just wide of the corner. Rattel goes back in the net as the Rangers are really putting on tremendous pressure. Here's Rattel. He's checked. Mike Walton. Trying to pull away. Gets up to center. Mike Walton over the line. Closes in. Centered it. And there was nobody there to get it. Sealing gets it back to Gilbert. Gilbert up at center. Over the blue line. Closing in. Dropped it back to Egers. Egers shot it to an open wing. Rattel. Dropping it to Gilbert. Centered it up in front. It hits Clinton. Walton's got it. Walton shot it for Harrison on the right wing. Over the line. Stopped by Rattel for Egers. Egers back to Rattel. Up at center. Shot it over the line offside. 1 minute and 54 seconds left in the second period. Out-of-town score. Detroit leading Minnesota 2-0. Rolf from Libet and Bond. Libet from Unger. The times of the goals were 12 seconds and 6:41 respectively. Kachuk lost the puck to Keon, and offside was Monahan as McMillan was in alone. New York Rangers 4, Toronto Maple Leafs 2. It was 2-1 Leafs at the end of the first period, and New York Rangers have scored 3 unanswered goals in the second. Goes back to Glennie, over to Rick Lee. Shot the puck into the New York Rangers zone. McMillan to Keon. Keon back for Monahan, back of the net, centered it out in front, and it's Malone to Fairburn over the line. Fairburn trying to go around Glennie. Olakachuk lost the puck. Keon couldn't get out. Now it's McMillan and Monahan, broken up by Ernie Brown. Monahan shoots it out. McMillan didn't see it. Keon goes after it. Goes back into the leaf zone, and Glennie knocked it over the blue line. And Fairburn shot it right back again at Klaus.
Last minute of play in this period.
Less than a minute to go in the second period. Monahan and Ricky Lee bumped together. Monahan shot it way offside as Keon was inside the blue line, and the Maple Leafs are a little bit disorganized at this point. Montreal now leading Chicago 5-1. Yvon Cornoyer from Béliveau at 11:51. And they face off. The puck is on the far boards. App shot it into the crowd, and we'll do it all over again. That's still App's number 6 with Nevin number 8 and Vic Hadfield number 11. Hellman facing off against Apps. The puck goes to Hadfield and Nielsen. Nielsen over to Sealing. Up to Hadfield. Back to Nielsen. Off Apps over the line. Shot out again. Goes back into the corner. Dory back of the net. Hits the puck himself. Taken out of the play by Apps, who skated him off beautifully. Goes into the corner, picked up by Henderson. Henderson then trying to get it out, gives it to Dory, and there goes the bell to end the second period with the New York Rangers scoring 3.
Dory and Silwood.
Rodney faceoff, the Leafs fail to get it over the line. Hadfield shoots it out to center ice. Apps is covered by Silwood, who shot the puck right, a deflection to Keon. Here goes the shot, and that was blocked by Sealing. Keon's got it again, centered it out, and McMillan missed it. Back for Hadfield at center, a long shot. Plott steered it into the corner.
Hatfield tried to center it. Nevin does. Apps went after the loose puck, and Dory gets it. Jim Dory to Keon. Back to Dory at his own blue line, up the center. Back to Keon. It was behind him. McMillan chopped it to an open wing. Keon wraps it around the boards into the Ranger zone. Ceiling back for it. He fell. Keon after him. Keon steals the puck. Centered it. McMillan shoots. A great save by Millen. They pile on top of the puck. And there may be a penalty here for the New York Rangers. Let's have a look at that. Here's the pass out in front. McMillan gets his shot away, and a nice save by Villemure. Here comes the penalty to seal it. Ceiling of New York will likely get a holding penalty. We'll wait for it officially. It's in a faceoff. It's in the Rangers zone to the right.
New York penalty to number 16, Ceiling. 2 minutes for deliberately holding the puck. The time, 55 seconds.
55 seconds is the time of the holding the puck penalty. And they face off. It's Walton keeping the puck in. He's watched by Rattel. Walton for Henderson. He skated off. The puck goes to Arnie Brown off the boards, but not out. Henderson keeps it in. It's wrapped around on the boards. Picked off there by Rattel. When Rattel shoots the puck down the ice, just missed the linesman. Ricky Lee back for it with 18:37 remaining in the game. 1:30 left in the penalty to Ceiling. They play every man up this time. Shot in, Villemure knocked it down, turned it around on the boards. Back by Brad Park, he deflected it out. Lee's picked it up, Rick Lee passing it right up Ross Stewart's skate, lost it. Ricky Lee gets it again, over for Henderson. Henderson trying to center it. Ullman gets a hold of the puck, back to Walton. Over for Ellis. Ellis left it there for Ullman. Ullman trying to get it back. Mike Walton helps him out. Trying to center it for Ullman. Randy Brown is checked. Ellis took a shot, and that hit a leg and went into the corner. Stewart is trying to hold it with a skate, and he does, for a faceoff in the New York Rangers zone of the line.
Galaxy 500, the perfect blend of full-size luxury, value, and economy. Take a quiet break in a Ford Galaxy 500. See your Ford dealer.
43 seconds left in the penalty to Ceiling. New York Rangers 4, Toronto Maple Leafs 2, 17:48 remaining in the game. On the draw, Nielsen is given a bump by Ellis. Ullman gets the puck, sent it out, but the Walton shoots. And it was snapped by the low line. Ullman goes back with Kachuk, one man back. They're over the blue line. Closing in, Kachuk shoots. Oh, Clark needs the save on the short side. As Horton had got up into the play as well.
Not only did Pond make a great save on that play, Bill, but the thing that impressed me was the way that young Brad Selwood played a two-on-one break. He stayed right in the middle, and he made Waller Kachuk shoot the puck. He didn't give him a man to pass it to.
New York Rangers 4, Toronto Maple Leafs 2, 17:33 remaining in the game. Here's Kachuk with it again. Rangers are playing a man short. Kachuk turns, gets his shot away, and that was deflected, and the Leafs bring it out. Ullman chased back, gets it over to Selwood. Up over the blue line, a quick pass for Henderson into the Rangers zone. Ballone skated off by Henderson. The puck is loose. Nielsen to Ballone. Ballone up to Kachuk, and he just lets it slide to center ice. Jim Dory back for it. Ceiling is back on the ice. So the Rangers are full strength as Dory shoots the puck into the Rangers zone. Villemure out of the net. Shot it off the boards for Fairburn. Broken up by Liddington. Liddington couldn't center it for the Maple Leafs. Puck is shot out to center ice. Stopped there by Dory. Dory just flicks it right back in again. Sitting after it. Martin gets in ahead of him. Malone
holds it there. Horton is in on the inside, and it's called for a faceoff in the New York Rangers zone to the left. 16 minutes and 33 seconds remaining in the hockey game. New York Rangers 4, Toronto 2. Darryl Sittler at center ice with Liddington on one wing, Harrison on the other. The puck goes loose. It's in front of the defense. Finally picked up by Fairburn. Fairburn gets up to center ice with Kachuk. Over the line. Kachuk gets it over to Lindstrom. His shot is stopped by Harrison. Harrison up to Sittler. Over to Liddington. Over the blue line and they're checked. Puck shot back to center. Ricky Lee over to Ken Murray, number 7, out there for the first time in the game on the defense for the Leafs. It goes into the Rangers zone. Nielsen shoots it around on the boards to Malone, and it's knocked back out to center ice. 15:54 to go in the hockey game, 4-2 New York. Puck was shot back in the Rangers zone again. Villemure there to Arnie Brown. Arnie Brown starting up with Don Luce. Fairburn. Fairburn reaches after it. Tags it along the boards. He's given a bump. Luce gets it out in front of the net. There's a shot. Another shot. And that was stopped. A whack by Eagers. Plot stopped that. It's all around in front of the net and they hold it out. Play is called.
We've got something for you to see. It's the little car with the better ideas, the 1971 Mercury Comet. You can get a choice of sixes or a V8. There's a two-door Comet, too. Nifty, isn't it? Hey, listen, better than looking here, see your Mercury dealer now. He'll let you have a real close look at Comet, without a hockey game to interrupt.
Faceoff is in the Maple Leaf zone to the left. Rattel out there now at center right with Eagers and Jobert. Bad part, couldn't keep it in. He dragged it out and shot it back in again, as you saw. So that means a faceoff outside the blue line. Keon, Monahan and McMillan. Dory and Silwood. Pass was behind Dory. Dory wraps at the center ice, stopped by Brad Clark to Rattel. Gerald Rattel to the Leaf line. Dory got a piece of him. McMillan in for Monahan, tipped it at center. Brad Clark was playing up, took the puck away from him, gives it to Rattel, back to Brad Clark. Now then, over the line was Arnie Brown, but Rod Gilbert stepped over ahead of him. And the tempo of the game has slowed down somewhat, Bob, due to the tenacious checking of the New York Rangers. Keon gets McMillan going down the right wing over the line with Keon. The pass in front. Villemure has got it and he holds onto it. Faceoff will be in the New York Rangers zone to the left. 14 minutes and 49 seconds left. New York Rangers 4, Toronto 2. Out for the first time, number 15, Britt Selby for the Maple Leafs now with Walton. Here's a shot. He's got Trecce out there with him. Walton center it. Selby didn't see it. Played by Horton around on the boards for Nevin. Up on the wing for Apps. Mike Walton. Tipped it back into his own zone, and Ken Murray, number 7, is back there for him. Murray waiting for Walton, takes it himself, shot it off the boards. Selby goes back, he's hit hard, play is called.
That's a look at Britt Selby, Bill, making his first appearance tonight, his first actual league appearance. He's been out with an injury for about 3 weeks.
Ricky Lee back of the net, shot it over for Britt Selby. It came back to Horton. He took his shot. That's deflected over the glass. And a spectator caught that one one-handed.
He made it look easy.
Looked a little bit like Brooke Robinson back there, didn't he?
He sure did.
The puck goes back into the corner. Rick Lee shot it to Ken Murray on the right wing. Hatfield checked him, and the puck goes up into the box seats. New York 4, Toronto 2, 14:07 to go in the game. Goes back to Ken Murray, shot it off the boards, up the center ice, ceiling is tapped. Takes his shot, and Villemier covered the short side. Hache went for a spill into the boards. It's Apps then for Nevin. Apps went to steal the puck, and it's grabbed off by Rick Lee. Lee, a long pass for Walton, and that just failed to click as Morton speared it at the last second. Apps to Ceiling. Ceiling trying to hand it back. Rick Lee comes up over the blue line. Trying to get it in front. He's knocked down. Up the ice for Nevin. He just shoots it down the ice. That's going over the red line. And back to touch it was Murray, and that's icing.
Okay, Bob.
We'll look at Guy Trotsche. He's part of that Horton deal of late last season. An impressive goal scorer with Buffalo in the American League. He's had 45 and 55 goal seasons. If he could come through with a few for the Leafs, would make that Horton deal look pretty good.
13 minutes and 20 seconds left. New York Rangers 4, Toronto 2. Hellman gets the draw back to Dory. He took his shot. It's right in front of the net. It goes into the corner. And Annie Brown is propped there by Henderson. And that's where play ends. Toronto Maple Leafs now trying to carry the play to the New York Rangers, trailing by two. Rangers get the draw. Arnie Brown chased back, gets it up on the skate to Malone. Malone then to Kachuk, stopped by Dory. Ellis knocked it back into his own zone. Dory goes after him. Dory's pass stopped by Malone. Kachuk lets one go. As Dory handed it to Malone. Malone. Then to Kachuk again. The Rangers move every man up. Goes back to Arnie Brown's shot, and Plott stopped that. Dory trying to get the puck out. Malone keeps it in. Dory back for it. Shot it off the glass, but not out. Now then Ellman tries his luck and gets it out over the blue line. Brad Park hands it to Ellman. Ellman down the ice, over the line, offside was Ronnie Ellis. By a good foot.
We'll take a look at that bit of business with Dory losing the puck in the end. The Toronto end going off Ballone's skate, and Plott having to come out, and this puck is loose here. He can't quite reach it, and the Toronto defenseman coming over missed it, and Plott had to recover to save it himself.
He can't come any closer than that, Bob, on that score. Gilbert's pass back to Nielsen, up for Rattel, over on the wing for Egers, and Rattel has to cover up. Harrison nearly got loose. Egers to Rattel, back to Egers. He's over the line, giving a bump. Leafs come up with it. Lennington to Harrison, over the line with Walton. Walton takes the pass, trying to cut in, and he was chased off to the boards. Harrison steals the puck, and Villemier gets a hold of it with his glove, and there's no further play. Jacques Lemaire has scored for Mickey Redmond at 4:19 of the final period in Montreal, and the Canadiens are way ahead of the Blackhawks, 6-1. It's New York 4, Toronto 2, as Trotsche is coming out now. Harrison with Walton and Lennington. Here it rolls right to Villemier. He cleared it back of the net to Nielsen, over to Gilbert back to Littell up at center. Over the line to Gilbert. Gilbert back to Littell. Trache is skated off. E. Trache going back of the net. Yes, waits there. And a pass to Rick Lee for Lidington. He's checked. Littell has given a bump. Lidington's pass. Eager's kept it in. Ken Murray knocked it out again, and we have 10:59 to go in the hockey game. Tim Horton on this right wing. Up to the Leaf blue line. Stick handling through. Gets around. Ricky Lee centered it, and Littell just failed to get a hold of it. Here's Gilbert's shot. Murray goes after it in the corner. He shot it, but not out. Gilbert drops it right out of Walton's stick. Mike Walton winds up in his own zone. Walton up the center. Still has it. Tapped over top of Horton. And the puck goes into the Rangers zone, and Mike Walton putting out another dazzling display for the Maple Leaf fans here tonight. After the Leafs are having desperate trouble in their own zone, they keep giving the puck away. There's a second score! Nielsen to Gilbert. All he had to do was deflect it in as he handed back to the New York Ranger player. And that's what they're doing in their own zone, giving the puck away.
Put that hustle on here. Brad Selwood made a bad clearing pass and coming right back to Jimmy Nielsen. And as he shoots it, Gilbert just changed direction of it enough and tucked it by Plant on the short side.
New York goal scored by number 7, Gilbert. Assist, number 15, Nielsen. Time, 9:52.
9:52 is the time. The Leafs have the puck now in the Rangers zone. McMillan to Monahan, back of the net. He tried to center it, and Brad Park gets it. Brad Park to Silaps. Over on the wing to Hatfield. Hatfield turns around. Trying to get down the left wing. Shot the puck over the line. Silwood to Dory. He's partially blocked by Nevin, but comes up with it. Now you set up Keon. Puck is shot back into the lead zone, and it's Silwood. Up to Dory. Over to McMillan. And it's cleared out over the blue line as the Rangers are strictly defensive now and looking for the breaks. As the Leafs must come to them. Dory goes to the corner. Trying to center it. Hatfield along the boards. McMillan in there as well. Play is called.
Like to look racy? Put some romance in your life? And save money too? Hit the jackpot. Make yourself a Maverick Grabber. The sporty economy Maverick with hood scoops, optional buckets, and sporty looks. You'll save a lot of money. This year, let all the other sports go for broke. Make yourself a Maverick Grabber. The simple machine that always pays off. Ford gives you better ideas.
Coach Johnny McClellan is juggling his players around. He has Sittler at center ice now with Selby on one wing and Trache on the other. Sittler nearly got hit on the head with that shot by Selby. Trache keeps it in. Here's his shot, and that was stopped by Nielsen. Pretty good move by Guy Trache there to keep that puck in and then beat that one man, but Nielsen really felt that shot. Rangers get the puck up to center ice. Loose to Stewart. Back to Loose over the line. Centered it. Irvin gets the backhand away. That's stopped by Plott. And Sealing lets one go. And Irvin just failed to deflect it. Ken Murray over to Trache. Behind Sittler over to Selby. Gets it back to Ricky Lee. Lee to Ken Murray. Shot it over the line. Nielsen back for it. Got it around on the boards for Irvin. Irvin straight down the ice at center for Stewart. Offside. Ron Stewart went in advance of that pass.
Well, just a reminder to our viewers that next Saturday we'll have the Chicago Blackhawks here at the Gardens.
And as usual, that game will be brought to you in part by Ford of Canada and their Mercury and Ford dealer.
And Bob, and we have a face-off outside the Leaf blue line with 8 minutes and 8 seconds to go in the game. New York leading Toronto 5-2. Long shot. Plott steered that to the corner. Goes to Dory. Dory around on the boards to Henderson. Up for Ullman. He's too well covered. Here's Walter Kachuk, and he's checked by Selwood. Ullman up at center. Over the Ranger line to Henderson. Henderson is dumped. Walter Kachuk comes back to Lona on his left. Fairburn on the right. Offside. Out of town score is now 6-2 at Montreal. Mackey from Bobby Hull and Jarrett, 5:41 of the final period. Malone back to Horton. Goes to Dory. Dory shot it out to Henderson. He knocked it down with his glove, stopped by Fairburn. And Kachuk comes back out over the line again. They're all tangled up against the boards. We'll have another face-off. Seven minutes and 25 seconds remaining. New York Rangers 5, Toronto 2. Brad Park shot the puck into the Leafs zone. Dory gets it over to Selwood. Up for Ullman, a race for it. Ellis cutting in. There's the shot. Jim Dory shot it over, and look out, that goes into the crowd and out again. And hit the crossbar in front of the first row box seats.
One thing in that play, that shot of Ellis, I would think by the time Bill Lemieux stopped coming out on him to cut down his angle, he was almost to the spot on the faceoff circle, just to his left. And he'd really come out, and if Ellis had scored on that, he would have been very fortunate because there wasn't much of a net for him to shoot at.
And they face off for Harrison on the right wing. He's out there with Walton and Lidington. Ceilings pass. Puck was stopped there by Ken Murray and Mike Walton. Walton lets his shot go, and that was hovered by Villemure. Harrison goes into the corner, tried to center it. Gilbert then for Rattel. Rattel gets it over on the wing to Egers. He's hit by Murray. And he lets one go, and Clark got a piece of it. And that went up into the crowd. 6 minutes and 37 seconds remaining in the game. New York 5, Toronto 2. New York Rangers are playing every man inside the blue line. That's Nielsen and Seelig. Playing well in. Eager shot the puck back to the net. Rattel was dumped by Ricky Lee. Gilbert was given a bump. It goes to Lidington. Lidington out over the blue line up the center. Into the Rangers zone. Seelig grabbed Lidington. He goes right on. Walton takes a shot that's wide. Goes to the far wing. Murray kept it in, then lost it to Rattel. Rattel gives it over on the wing to Egers. Here it goes, and that's wide. Leafs get back at center. Walton was checked. Egers to Gilbert, and Henry ran into Nielsen. Gilbert over to Seelig. Seelig just shoots the puck and hit the referee. Lidington was knocked off stride. Over the line offside as Gilbert was over the blue line.
It's elegant. It's bold. It's luxurious. The all-new Cougar XR7, a very personal luxury car, designed for people with a taste for action. Tachometer, floor shift, high back bucket seats, a 351 cubic inch V8, superbly crafted interiors. Mercury Cougar 1971, sophistication with a spirit of adventure.
It's getting better all the time.
All set for the face-off. Keon out there with McMillan and Monahan, along with Dory and Selwood. Keon coming out over his own blue line to center for McMillan. Villemure came out of the net to cover up. Hadfield shot it, but not out. Selwood wrapped it back in again.
Hatfield, then to Apps. Monahan knocked it over the line, as you saw with his glove, and his teammates were trapped inside. The Leafs led 2-1 at the end of the first period, New York 4-2 at the end of the second, and the Rangers have scored the only goal in this final period, Gilbert from Nielsen at 9:52. Apps takes a shot right on, knocked into the corner. Nevin gets the loose puck. Story goes after him to take it away from him. It's along the board. Story is tripped. There's going to be a penalty to Nevin. Tripping. With 5 minutes and 7 seconds left in the game.
Bob Nevin, the captain of the Rangers, took that penalty, Bill. It was certainly wasn't intentional.
New York penalty to number 8. Nevin. 2 minutes for tripping. Time 14:53.
Well, I say it wasn't an intentional trip. His stick just happened to get caught up in Dory's legs, but unfortunately for Nevin, the referee happened to be standing right there.
Now set to go in front of faceoff. The Leafs with the man advantage have the puck in their own zone. Walton, Keon, Oman, Henderson, and Ellis. Keon at center. Over the line, takes his backhand wide. The rebound off the board, Seeling going to try and hold it there. He does with Stewart. Faceoff will be in the New York Rangers zone to the right. 4:50 remaining in the game, 1:43 in the penalty.
Well, look at Ted Irvin. This is the player that the Rangers picked up last year in a deal with L.A., and they sent Juha, Weeding, and Real Lemieux to them, and he's a pretty tough boy.
Leafs play every man up now with 4:50 left. Puck is near that Ranger goal. Seeling shot it around on the board. Stewart checked by Ellis. Then Nielsen beats Ellman to the puck, but Henderson is there. Henderson trying to dig it out. So is Ellman. Back to Henderson. Back to Keon. Over to Walton. That shot was knocked back of the net. Henderson after it, covered by Seeling. It's shot back to Keon. Keon fakes a shot, Walton and shot it high. Ellis back to Keon again, and it rolled over his stick out the center ice. Now Ellis gets it again. He goes over the line, takes his shot. Seeling knocked it down and cleared it down the ice between Walton and Keon. 3:58 remaining in the game. 5-2 as Walton takes the pass. There's the shot, and that's wide. Ellis tried to get the rebound. Ellman trying to center it. Picked off by Brad Park, and he shoots it down the ice. 34 seconds left in the penalty to Nevin. Mike Walton to Dory. Dory over the line, tried to go all the way. Walton was just checked by Horton at the last second. 15 seconds left in the penalty to Nevin as the puck goes into the Ranger zone. Horton has it. Clearing pass ahead for Irvin. Irvin trying to cut in, does. Took a shot, blast off that. A drive by Kachuki, score! Be any goal on the play, but there will be a penalty.
Well, take a look at that again, and Ted Irvin making a real good play in there. Is cut down. Here's Dory pulling him down as he makes his play. Follows into the net, blocked, make the original stop, lost the puck, and when the rebound came loose, there was no one in the net, and Ron Stewart just fired it over his.
New York ball scored by number 18 to 2. Assist number 27, Irvin, and number 3, Horton. The time, 16:52.
So the referee has ruled that the New York Ranger player was shoved into the crease. Well, that makes it New York 6, Toronto 2, and it's Tkachuk getting it to Ballone over the line. His pass broken up. Knocked at the center ice. Made back to Dory. Dory gives it then to Sittler for Selby, and it's knocked into the crowd. 2:44 left. Well, Jacques Plante argued to no avail on that one, Bob.
Well, I thought at first that he was going to call it no goal, and as you said, give Jim Dory a penalty for pulling Ted Irvin down, but I guess he saw fit to let the goal stand. Irvin certainly wasn't in there of his own accord.
Well, the reason I thought that he wasn't going to call the goal is because Plante, after talking to him, just shook his head and said thank you and went back to the net. Then he changed his mind. 2:34 left as Trecce comes out now on the right wing to his own blue line up at center. Gets over the line. Dory lets one go, and Villeneuve stopped that. Sittler after it. He hit the referee. Trecce trying to center it. It's back of the net. Sittler does center it, but there's nobody there. Fairburn to Ballone. Up at center. Over the line. Ballone still has it. Trying to slip it in front of the net, and Dory gets it. Dory shot it out on the right wing to Selby with 2 minutes left. Horton traps the puck to Fairburn. Fairburn out to Ballone, too far. Ken Murray shoots it off the boards. Here's the chance for Monahan. He lets his shot go. It's weak and wide. Nielsen after it for the Rangers. 1:40 left. Tapped by Monahan again, a shot, and that's wide. It's kept in by Keon, then knocked out again. Ken Murray gets it over on the left side to Monahan, over the line with Keon, and his pass was blocked by Sealing. Then Vicky Lee right in front to McMillan. Another try, and Keon tried to put it in the corner. It was knocked out by Nielsen. The puck is still in the Ranger zone. Gilbert coming up at center, then to Nielsen. Shot it over the line. It goes to Plante. Cleared it out on the left side to Monahan.
Last
to Keon.
Play in the game.
At center. Less than a minute to go. He rides on Sealing and gets his shot away. Villeneuve into the corner to Rattel, up to Eagers. Eagers takes a long shot. That's wide and weak. Monahan goes to the board. Eagers knocked him down. Keon into McMillan. McMillan a long shot. That was stopped by Villeneuve and shot out the center. Going back for it is Liddington, number 26, with 28 seconds left. Liddington's pass for Keon. Keon over the line, takes his shot, and that's up over the glass.
Mercury's Little Comet comes in two sizes, small and smaller, six cylinders or eight. 1971 Mercury Comet, the little car with a better idea.
21 seconds remaining. New York 6, Toronto 2. That's Apps facing off with Walton offside. Dory brought it in. The New York Rangers have been really checking tonight, Bob. And the faceoff, Apps at center, gets it over to Hatfield. Hatfield turns around. Back with Apps, over the line to Hatfield. The shot, Plante stopped that with 8 seconds. Nevin centered it right in front of the net. Apps tried to get a shot on goal. It came out in front of the net. Goes back to Ernie Brown. There's the shot. There goes. The game is over. It was deflected in, but the bell is blue, and the red light can't come on, so there's no goal. New York 6, Toronto 2. In just a moment, our three-star selection.